Hi, warm welcome to you. We are actually continuing with the problems and trigonometric ratios. So let's try to solve these problems. The first problem, if sine theta equal to minus 1 by 3 and theta does not lie in the third quadrant, find the values of cos theta and cot theta. So we have been given that sine theta is equal to minus 1 by 3, that's nothing but sine is negative. If you take up 4 quadrants, all sine, cos and tan. Sine is negative in 3rd and 4th quadrant. It's already given that sine is not in 3rd quadrant, so theta is in 4th quadrant. We know that theta is in 4th quadrant. Now we have to find out the values of cos theta and cot theta. So I'll go for a right angle triangle. If I say this is theta, then sine theta is minus 1 by 3. That means this is minus 1. This is 3. You can calculate this. This is 9 minus 1, 8. Square root is 2 root 2. So we have to find out cos theta. Cos theta value is equal to, if I go adjacent by hypotenuse, that's 2 root 2 by 3. And we are in 4th quadrant. In the 4th quadrant, sorry, that's a blunder, happens. In the 4th quadrant, cos is positive, so cos theta is 2 root 2 by 3. And we have to find out what is the value of cot theta. Cot theta is nothing but cot theta is nothing but adjacent by opposite, that is 2 root 2 by minus 1, that's nothing but equal to minus 2 root 2. So what we have used here is that it's given that theta does not lie in third quadrant and sine is negative. Sine is negative only in third and fourth quadrant. All sine, tan and cos. All sine, tan and cos. In 4th quadrant, cos is positive. That's why this is positive. Now we have drawn a right angle triangle. Based on that, we have found the value of cot theta. Let's look at this one. This seems to be interesting. Secant theta plus tan theta equal to 5. Given to us that secant theta plus tan theta equal to 5. Now if I know this, I know that secant square theta minus tan square theta equal to 1. This is in the form of a square minus b square. So I can write it as a plus b into a minus b. So I know that secant theta plus tan theta is equal to 1 by secant theta minus tan theta. So applying this, I can write secant theta minus tan theta is nothing but equal to 1 by secant theta plus tan theta, that is 1 by 5. Now I'll add this to, if I add this, I get 2 secant theta is equal to 26 by 5. That gives me secant theta equal to 13 by 5, which gives cos theta equal to 5 by 13. And if you now go ahead with the Pythagoras theorem, you can see that sin theta is nothing but equal to 12 by 13. How we got it? We got it because there is a right angle triangle. Cos theta, that means this is 5, this is 13. 169 minus 25, 144, square root is 12. So sin theta equal to 12 by 13. And sin and cos both are positive in which quadrant? Both are sin, cos and positive in first quadrant. So theta lies in first quadrant and the value of sin theta is 12 by 13. Let's solve this one. We have been asked to find out the value of cot pi by 20, 3 pi by 20, this is 20, 5 pi by 20, 7 pi by 20 into 9 pi by 20. We have to prove that this is equal to 1. Prove that this is equal to 1. So let's go ahead and do that. Now what I will do here is, I'll just keep this part as it is. So I will write cot pi by 20 into cot 3 pi by 20. Now the logic is, pi by 20 is 9 degrees, cot 5 pi pi by 20, this is nothing but equal to 45 degrees, and that value is equal to 1. If I am getting here 1, that means remaining all should strike with each other so that I will get the value as 1. So I'll just go ahead and I'll put it as it is. I'll say cot 5 pi by 20, and I will write this cot 7 pi by 20. 7 pi, I can write it as 10 pi minus 3 pi by 20. That is nothing but pi by 2 minus 3 pi by 20. I can write it as pi by 2 minus 3 pi by 20 into cot of pi by 2 minus pi by 20. Now if you see here, this is equal to same cot pi by 20. The next is also same, cot 3 pi by 20. We know cot 5 pi by 20 is nothing but equal to 1, and cot of 90 minus cot of pi by 2 minus theta is tan. We are in first quadrant, so that's positive, tan 3 pi by 20. Similarly here it is tan pi by 20. Cot and tan cancels it out and you are left with 1. In the next video, we'll try to solve some more problems. Thanks for visiting. Bye for now.